The country of Guinea has only 1% of Africa's population, but 10% of all deaths related to snakebite. With over 3,200 deaths and 24,000 envenomations every year, why am I going there to find these snakes and capture images of them? I went on this journey with the Asclepius Snakebite Foundation, and I had a massive challenge ahead of me. Not only did I need to capture images of these animals, but I needed to do it in a way that was inspiring and educational, because these images would help tell the story of snakebite in West Africa and help raise money to save lives.
We are radio tracking a green mamba that we placed a transmitter in about a month ago. It's been out down sort of in this valley for a few weeks now, and we're gonna go see if it's in the same tree and see if he's done anything exciting since we last saw it.
So I should have brought my tripod today, but we're at the green mamba that we've been tracking for Eric. It's very dark under these canopies, so you're tossing between very high noise in your image and trying to reduce motion blur. Holding up the camera at such a sharp angle up and out, your arms get tired very quickly. So looking at it and then trying to find it through your viewfinder or your back LCD screen, it's a lot trickier than you might originally think. Getting the image tomorrow, definitely a tripod, but I can see his face today, so I probably took 100 photos of this thing. But yeah.
Getting where you're going can be tough, but it doesn't have to be for your reptile. For safe and reliable shipping, look no further than to Reptiles To You. From top-of-the-line communication to working with the carriers to ensure reliable and trustworthy service, you can know that while you navigate life's challenges, they can handle the transportation of your animal. So go on down to reptiles2you.com and check them out.
One major accomplishment of the ASF team was finding the first live black mamba in the country of Guinea. Along the route where we were going to radio track the green mamba was a black mamba basking at the edge of a bush.
It looks like a perfect basking spot here. You've got this nice limb that comes out over the roadway, and I think it's interesting, you know, from talking to other members of the team, they've passed by here and they've had to move out of the way from this branch when the truck goes by, and who knows how long that mamba was there basking.
Yeah, so despite it being pretty warm in the car as we're driving, we have our windows rolled up. Getting hit in the face with a branch is one thing, but getting hit in the face with a black mamba would be a whole different story.
So we're here at the Serpentarium. Again, we have the first black mamba that's been caught in Guinea. We have a lot of different people here to make sure that this goes smoothly, and this is very exciting to be a part of.
Before extracting venom from the black mamba, we gave it a mild dose of ketamine. And this was a tricky balancing act. Give it too much, and you're gonna affect the snake's health. But give it too little, and the snake can be volatile.
Okay, he's coming up towards you guys there, so just, he's good.
Okay.
No, let's head out. Okay, mana, bon travail.
In addition to extracting the venom, we logged the length, the weight, and the sex of the snake. And we also took a blood and a scale sample for future research.
Yeah.
After all this, and we were leaving the lab, we were approached by two local boys with a ball python in hand. A wild ball python. Amazing.
So photographing this scorpion is tricky with these blades of grass.
It's just definitely something you want to do right and get some good shots.
And this is an emperor scorpion, which is one of the largest scorpion species in the world, common here in West Africa.
but also common in the pet trade in the United States and elsewhere. They've got these huge, powerful pincers on the front, very imposing looking stinger. What's nice, I guess, about these scorpions is that they're not that medically significant, or they're not really, dangerous, other than the sting causing a lot of pain, maybe some other local effects. Not something you want to get stung by, but if you do, it's not going to cause you as many problems as some of the other more neurotoxic scorpions.
Another night of herping held some amazing results. Arachnids, chameleons, and some more snakes.
That is amazing.
Isn't it cool? So,
yeah, every time.
This
is so great. This is a
new breed. Believe. One
plus. Sakara,
you
think you
could out here too? I kind of agree. Mambis. Mambas. Mambas.
Oh my god.
Mambas. Yep, he's up high.
We've joked about making a seed collection.
There's a big thing of iridescent blue wasps hanging on the underhang of that cave.
I don't want these guys.
Yeah.
There we go.
Just outside of the clinic, we had a tree that held many baby chameleons. I believe there were eggs laid at the base of the tree, and then when they hatched, they would ascend the tree to begin the first days of their lives. And with that, I was able to document these baby chameleons and give insight into their first days. Unintentionally, I even had one piggyback with me on my camera bag, which I found at the clinic the next day.
He's dark right now too.
Yeah, he looked darker.
Talk about immersion. In the clinic, we have a baby chameleon that was just fountain crawling around. Look at him.
It just goes to show you how amazing and diverse this place is, that you can just find a chameleon in a room. My theory is that he might have been one of those babies that I was photographing yesterday, and he just hijacked a ride on my backpack. So I put him back where we found him.
As we settled down for the night, a local came up and informed us that there was a snake just outside of one of the houses. So we got up, grabbed our gear, and went running to their house.
Closest?
We found a spotted night adder.
Panui.
Reports from locals being common and unexpected, we even got one report while we were out in the field of one particular snake.
Okay. So while we were radio tracking the green mamba in the tree that we've been following, we got a call about another green mamba in a tree in somebody's village, and so we are on our way there now to go and get it out, climb the tree, and remove the snake for these people.
I
Nabi, who's an incredible feat of a human being, climbed 25 meters to pursue the green mamba. I know it was 25 meters because I sent my drone up to get the first ever footage of a venomous snake capture with the drone. The snake was set to land on our landing pad and was safely captured.
Très bien!
If you want to support the Asclepius Snakebite Foundation, check them out on social media or go to snakebitefoundation.org. I strongly encourage you to donate or to share any of their work with as many people as you can. Whether it's this video or one of the many things that they put out showcasing the medical work, the training, and the research that they do. Guys, thanks so much for watching. If you want to see another expedition I've done, I've got my Indonesia series, and then I've got my Peru video. So make sure you check them out. But until then, I'll see y'all next time.